Today's video, we're going to be diving into 5 apps that you didn't know you needed that you might want to explore in daily productivity. So we're going to dive into 5 resources, their websites or tools, and also suggest alternatives if you are interested too, as to explore options in the market. So welcome, my name's Francesco. If you're interested, you can check out toolfinder.co, our place to find tools. And also we have a brand new newsletter called New Tools. If you want 3 new tools every 2 weeks landed in your inbox, then you can join that newsletter below. We have over 500 people and we only launched it a few weeks ago. So the first tool on our list is a goal planner. A lot of people don't think about having a goal planner, but can be a great way to focus on not just the task, but the zoom out approach of what you're doing. Now, there are a few different options. I've checked out one recently called Gripply. Gripply is an interesting solution as it manages the goals, tasks, and your habits in one place. And what I quite like about it is that there's this almost this vision board type approach, which allows you to just plan out what you want to focus on per area of your life, which is really nice. Now, there are alternatives to these type of apps, like for example, Timestripe, that zooms out in perspective and helps you to see the full picture and be able to keep that in mind as you plan your daily goals. But these sort of apps, an incredible tool to help zoom out and focus on not just the tasks in your life, but everything else. Number 2 is a time tracker. Now, a lot of people think a time tracker might only be for people working with clients or billable hours, but it can be one of the biggest insights to your own productivity. I always used to recommend every 3 months, spend a week using a time tracker to see where you spend your time, and you'll be amazed on how much time you spend on certain things. For example, being able to see all this data at the end can be a great way to just go, this is an audit and this is what I need to change. And for a lot of people, this is a game changer in how they perceive their productivity. Well, here are some options. The first is Rize, which is a good one if you're looking for a more intense one. It's also got an assistant if you get the pro that'll nudge you back into the app that you're using. It is a good one, but there are alternatives that are out there like Freedom and other such solutions. Number 3 is an app blocker. Now, there are loads of different types of app blockers. Some of the time tracking apps we mentioned before actually have them, but app blockers can be a great way to really get into a routine of stopping your usage. We did a video about how to reduce your phone here on YouTube. If you're interested, you can find it below. But largely, there's one called OneSec, which basically, when you go into an app like Instagram or Twitter, whatever you set them up as, it'll push you out of that app and ask you a prompt of whether you want to go into it, giving you a bit of intention to focus on. These sort of apps are great for app blocking and making sure that you're reducing your screen time as a collective. So an interesting solution for those who want to be able to reduce the amount of time they spend on their phone. And I believe you can get it for Mac, I'm not too sure. So the 4th solution is these cleaner of emails. So there's this concept out there where basically you plug in an email tool and it will essentially clean up your inbox. There's a couple of solutions that are out there. The most well-known one is SaneBox, but there's also another one called Clean Email. And these sort of apps are great because they work with any email client, work in the background, clean your email and putting them into the right folder so you can process them and train them, and then basically have that reduction of email and putting stuff that's important. This is a great way to reduce the noise and focus on what's important. Some apps, email clients even have stuff like this. You can set this up in apps like Superhuman, but these work with pretty much any email client that's out there. So well worth considering an email cleaner to be able to just take the weight from your inbox. And finally, number 5 is a relationship manager. Now, this isn't you dating, this isn't Tinder. But it is a software that's basically going to take all your relationships through LinkedIn, through your messages, and be able to keep a tally of them so that you can keep your contacts nice and engaged. And this isn't just for salespeople, and it isn't just like a process thing. It's a good reminder-based app. And I personally use a software called Clay. What it does is quite nice. It basically is an app that allows you to see all your LinkedIn contacts and it will resurface them when you haven't contacted or interacted in that person with quite a while. So I quite like that because I like to keep in touch with a lot of people, see what they're getting up to, and just in general, be in good relation with them. Like, it's nice to be able to see what they're doing and you to share what you're doing as well. So this one keeps basically resurfacing right ones. You can even leave little notes for yourself. I'm sure there are other softwares like this. I believe Lunatask have a relationship ability in their app. And I know a lot of people use this manually in Notion to be able to track their own relationships, but it's great to see these sort of apps and solutions for being able to keep those relationships in check. So those are probably 5 tools that you didn't know you needed, but you may be interested in at least one of them after. after this video. Again, you can sign up to the new tool newsletter linked below, and you can check out any tools and resources over on Toolfinder. We'll help you find the best software for work and life. Thanks so much for stopping by, and I'll see you later, I'm sure. Cheerio for now.